undisputed king of beers. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council. The president, Jose Suleiman, supervisor at ringside, Robert Bussey, along with the California State Athletic Commission, the chairman, William Eastman, vice chairman, Willie Buchanan, executive director, Richard DeCure. Introducing to you our judges, scoring this bout from ringside, Terry Smith, Dick Young, and Tom Tomihara. Introducing our referee in charge, he'll be giving instructions after the introductions, Vince Delgado. All right, fans, here we go with our rematch main event of the evening, the WBC Super Bantamweight Championship of the World, scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you first the challenger on my left, fighting out of the red corner, wearing blue trunks with white trim, fighting out of Mexico City, Distrito Federal, Mexico. He weighed in at the super bantamweight limit of 122 pounds with a veteran record of 50 wins, 7 losses, and 3 draws. He has 25 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the two-time super bantamweight champion of the world, Daniel Zaragoza. His opponent across the ring is the defending world champion on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing gold trunks and hailing from Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic, now fighting out of the Bronx in New York. He weighed in the same weight as his opponent at 122 pounds even. His record includes 32 wins, 2 losses, and 3 draws, with 20 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, making the third defense of his title, please welcome the defending WBC Super Bantamweight Champion of the World, Hector Acero Sanchez. Once again, here's our referee in charge now to give instructions, Vince Delgado.
You had your instructions in the dressing room. Give me a nice clean fight, okay? Shake hands and good luck.
All right, let's check the tail of the tape. Zaragoza's 5'8", Acero Sanchez an inch shorter. They're both in at 122. Zaragoza is 7 years older than Acero Sanchez. In the reach department, Sanchez has an inch advantage. All right, the rules by WBC governing this fight. Winner of the round gets 10 points. Free knockdown is in effect. No standing eight count. Saved by the bell in the last round only. Referee or doctor can stop the fight. If they have a headbutt, they'll go to the cards after the third round. Here we go. Round one scheduled for 12. Zaragoza, the southpaw, he's in blue, trimmed in silver, and in the solid gold, with his name in black across the front of it, is Hector Acero Sanchez. Rich, I noticed that you were putting down all the super bantamweight title holders. Out of that crowd, really, Marco Antonio Barrera, I think, might be the best.
Yeah, he seems to be the standout. As we mentioned, Acero Sanchez here, of course, the WBC champ. Barrera is the WBO champion, Orlando Canizales the IBF title holder, and Antonio Cermeno the WBA champ.
Didn't Canizales, or doesn't he have the longest record as a title holder in defense of his crown?
That was at the bantamweight level, and he just won the 122 pound.
So he's starting
Saturday
a brand
night.
New one, huh?
Yes.
And he defeated the aforementioned
Julio Cesar Portillo. Now there you see some of the quickness of Acero Sanchez, Tom, as we start here in the gold trunks. Acero Sanchez throws punches from some awkward angles. He's very quick-handed, flat-footed here early, which is a bit of a surprise to me, but he can utilize the ring if he has to. If you notice, one thing I'm noticing about Acero Sanchez, boy, his legs are spread wide apart here. It's hard to imagine he could get very good balance that way. You take a look at him, that is a very widespread stance.
He looks like a guy who's expecting the wind tunnel to open up and try to blow him out of the ring. And he is really settling himself, and his feet are very, very far apart. Sanchez electrified the boxing world, and I'm sure the Patterson family, when he took this title away from Tracy Patterson back in 93.
That was quite an upset. He floored Patterson during the course. course of that fight, which turned out to be the difference in the score.
Patterson has since moved up in weight, but at the time he'd had a magnificent record, maybe only two losses and 50 wins. Have you ever heard from Floyd, incidentally? Floyd
has never, never have yet, no. My idol still hasn't picked up the phone and given me a ring yet.
You know, there's a lady down in the Newport Beach area by the name of Linda who watches all the time and is a very knowledgeable fight fan, and she thinks Floyd Patterson is just the greatest fighter she ever saw fight. And I told her that you are crazy about Floyd, and I can't believe that Floyd hasn't heard about this and sent you a note or something.
He'll call.
Oh, yeah, stay by the phone.
Thing I'm interested in seeing in this fight, Tom, is if Zaragoza, as Evander Holyfield did on Saturday night, gets old in one night here right before our eyes. You never know with fighters, and of course with Zaragoza at the age of 35, that's a distinct possibility.
Round one is coming to a close. It'll be a busy 12 rounds. We'll be back. Round number two, it's scheduled for 12. The man in the gold trunks is the current WBC super bantamweight champion. And the man in the blue trunks, Daniel Zaragoza. Rich Marotta, we're kind of watching a legend of boxing in action here tonight at 35 years of age. There's not much this man hasn't done.
And Tom, you're absolutely right. A pro career that began in 1980. And as I take a look at Zaragoza, and I'll run over some of that career, he is bleeding from the right eye, Tom. Zaragoza is bleeding here. And one thing that happened at the conclusion of the round when we broke for commercial, Zaragoza went right over to Vince Delgado, the referee, and indicated that Acero Sanchez was leaning in with his head and headbutting him.
Well, the cut opened in round one, and they worked on it between rounds, but they obviously have not got it closed yet.
Now, Zaragoza turned pro back in 80. In 1985, he won a title for the first time, the WBC Bantamweight Championship. He beat Freddie, remember Freddie Pebbles Jackson? Then he won the WBC title here at 122 at the Great Western Forum when he stopped the great Carlos Zarate in 1988. He had five defenses of that title, including wins over Paul Bankey and Frankie Duarte. And then in 90, he lost the title to Bankey, and he was stopped in nine rounds in just one of the most spectacular fights ever, I think, in California boxing.
In fact, we've got some tape on that fight. We're going to show it to you between rounds here as this bout goes along. Go ahead, Red.
And then he regained the title in 1991 himself, defeating a Japanese fighter, Kiyoshi Hatanaka. And believe it or not, Tom, you know, you mentioned this is his 17th title fight tonight. You know, this legend of Mexico, he's never fought a world title fight in Mexico. That's hard to believe.
That is an unbelievable statistic. The cut above his right eye. It is not a new thing for Daniel Zaragoza to bleed. When he fought Paul Bankey, it was a real bloodbath. It was an unbelievable night of bloodletting between the two men. And Zaragoza has always had a tough time and has readily bled. He's subject to cuts, and he opens up rather easily. And he's got one over his right eye now. He's the southpaw with his back to him. One tough guy, they call him the ultimate warrior, and who's to dispute a sobriquet like that? He knocked Acero Sanchez down in their fight in Connecticut back in June, and actually thought he had won it, and almost everybody, including my learned broadcast partner, Rich Marotta, thought that he had won that fight. But he didn't get the decision, didn't get the call, and as a result, this rematch, and Acero Sanchez remains as the WBC super bantamweight champion.
To be honest about it, Tom, I didn't really think there would be much controversy about the decision. I thought it was enough of a win for Zaragoza that it didn't enter my mind, really, that he might not win that decision.
Let's go into the corner with him, Rich, and we'll watch him work on that eye. Nacho Beristain, who is a legend in his own right as far as managers and handling fighters, working on the eye.
They're having a tough time stopping the bleeding on that eye. All right, as we go back to round two action, Zaragoza having trouble getting a clean shot at the champion, so he utilizes a little bit of a wrestling move there, Tom.
Yeah, in fact, I think he did that deliberately, Rich, to kind of prove the point that he was trying to get to Vince Delgado. This guy's been, you know, banging me around and muscling me around, and if you want to turn it into a wrestling match, okay. So we kind of picked Sanchez up and just to say, we can wrestle a little bit here if you want. Out they come. This is round number three.
I did not see Vince Delgado, the referee, notify the judges that there was a headbutt. And that's
in fact, he kind of looked at Zaragoza at the end of round one as if, what did you say and what are you talking about? You know, had a very quizzical look on his face.
So that being the case, the headbutt rule would not come into play here, at least from this particular cut. And the WBC rule that you went over at the start of the fight, Tom, is different from California because they have to complete three rounds as compared to the California rules where you only need to complete one round for them to go to the scorecards.
Now, can Sanchez punch with Zaragoza?
No, absolutely not. In fact, I don't think he's much of a puncher at all. I'm surprised that he put it to Tracy Patterson down in that fight. I think he'd have to come up with just one of those real quick lightning-like punches that a fighter just doesn't see to put a guy on the deck at this, you know, at this level. He scored a lot of KOs, but not at this level.
This is a very rough fight. I'm sure you've come to that conclusion. Zaragoza has complained of being butted, although it has not officially been recorded as such. You saw Sanchez spin Zaragoza around and whack him a couple of times when he had his back to him. Of course, there's the old adage, you know, protect yourself at all times. The Marquis of Queensberry has some rules, but this sweet science is indeed a tough one. You better take care of yourself every minute and every second of the 3 minutes you're in the round.
And Zaragoza is the type of fighter, Tom, who will not be bothered, I don't think, by that cut. If, you know, he's been around long enough, he's been cut enough times to just think, well, you know, hey, I'm bleeding, I'll just keep going. He's pawing at it a little, but I don't think it discourages him the way it might a younger fighter.
No, that's true. I mean, there isn't much that Zaragoza hasn't seen or experienced in a ring in a career that started 15 years ago. Good countering left hand by Acero Sanchez.
See, he's hard to get a clean shot on, Tom. He did a nice job there of slipping two punches by Zaragoza. And again, slipping two more. He's just really moving his head well. A lot of upper body movement. Acero Sanchez, tough to hit.
Yep. It's Delgado going to be a very busy third guy in the ring here tonight. These two guys are his size, you know, and they bookends, and he's right in between them. It'll be a busy night for him. Scheduled for 12, with the WBC Super Bantamweight crown on the line. Nice crowd on hand. And even though Acero Sanchez is Hispanic, he is not going to be much of a fan favorite here tonight. He took some pretty good shots in the corner, including Zaragoza.
Including one looping left hook, and that's the first real strong, clean punch tonight that Zaragoza landed, and he felt it.
Round three coming to a close. We'll be back. Round number four scheduled for 12 for the Super Bantamweight title. Zaragoza is in the blue trimmed in silver. And in the gold trunks, the champion, Hector Acero Sanchez. Fernando Paramo told me that Zaragoza told him if he loses tonight, his boxing career is over and he will turn to managing or training fighters.
Yeah, and if that's the case, Tommy will have had a most successful career. Maybe not a legend, but nonetheless, he's been outstandingly successful. And I don't think, oh boy, he just got headbutted.
And knowing his history for bleeding, I think it probably has opened up. Yes, it's right up in the hairline.
And it's bleeding profusely. And I think he is discouraged now.
Yeah.
Even a great veteran like Zaragoza, he's very upset.
Now Delgado's taking a point away from the champion, Acero Sanchez. Blood streaming right down the middle of the forehead of Zaragoza.
And that's gonna go into his eyes, Tom. Maybe I'll cut that high on the head.
And of course, you know, right up in the hairline, the top of the head, or nearly so, if blood really flows freely from cuts up there, in this case a headbutt that results in a cut. So it's going to be a very bloody affair, the face of Daniel Zaragoza.
Right.
That in and of itself is not a new thing either, but it is going to get awfully messy here.
What Tom's trying to say, folks, if you have a weak stomach, be aware that this is going to be a bloodbath.
Zaragoza does bleed. And this is going to be a very roughhouse type of fight.
Yeah, these guys want to fight now. At least I know Zaragoza does.
Yeah. something you might see spilling out into the alley of your neighborhood bar, because these two guys are going to get after each other pretty good now. Not many of the niceties will be observed, I'm sure.
And it's up to Acero Sanchez here, Tom, too, to not panic in this in a situation and not get lured into a big slugfest. He needs to keep his poise and a box. But Zaragoza is getting to be like a wild man in there now. Here at the Forum when Zaragoza was by no means the crowd favorite. Many times he fought. When he fought the great Carlos Zarate, he wasn't. When he fought Paul Banky, he wasn't. When he fought Frankie Duarte here, he wasn't. But he certainly is tonight.
Yep. Round four is coming to a close. It's scheduled for 12. We'll watch along with you, I'm sure, between rounds as we... Boy, Zaragoza gave Sanchez a... If looks could harm you, there was one.
Leaning in, and there you see the clash of heads. They're both coming forward. I don't think that you can blame that on Acero Sanchez.
No, I don't think you can blame it really on either man. They just came together like two bull elephants ramming heads. It wasn't something that Sanchez certainly went out of his way to.
Beristain is really having a problem with that cut that's on the eyelid, Tom. It's a slit, and he's just having a hard time. He has yet to be able to stop the bleeding.
Well, in the past, as we've watched Zaragoza in action, it's been a two-handed job between rounds to stem the flow. Sanchez had a point taken away from him, Rich, in your scoring. Zaragoza knocked him down in their previous meeting in Connecticut. And again, it looks as though they may have butted heads, but... Sanchez has it.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like you could be an effective fighter fighting from that kind of a stance, Tom.
I think
that's the same kind of thing that got Lennox Lewis in real trouble when he had that terrible fight with McCall and when he fell into some bad habits. I'd like to see him close up that stance. Sanchez is a hard guy to get a clean shot of. Fernandez, who brought Jose Vita Ramos out here this summer to fight Jorge Paez.
Picked up the title, didn't he?
Good stable back in New York.
He'll be the WBO junior lightweight champion.
And he fight they enjoy fighting out here at the Forum. And I think he's bringing a lot of his people out here to fight for foreign boxing.
Well, it's known in boxing circles as the House of Upsets. And you bring a guy out to fight a local favorite, a guy who's expected to win, doesn't always turn out that way.
Certainly doesn't. We've seen that on many occasions.
Indeed.
Even when foreign boxing promotes fights at other locales.
That's right. The mystique of the House of Upsets travels with the promoter Antonio Curtis, or the matchmaker. John Jackson.
Acero Sanchez controlling the action in this round, Tom. He's not letting Zaragoza just wind up and walk into him.
Now, everything that Zaragoza does is magnified by the crowd's roar of approval, even though it is not always a big-time item. Two in their three fight schedule. Look at the slugfest these two guys put on.
This was one of the great fights in California history, Tom. Keep in mind that Zaragoza had won a wild first fight between the two, and then this was their second fight, a title fight, and they just went toe-to-toe at it, round after round. Zaragoza was in front, and there you see a familiar sight, blood coming from the right eye of Zaragoza. And as they approached round nine, Banky was down on points in this fight. Zaragoza appeared ready to retain his title, but instead he took that combination and went down. Somehow, he managed to get up, but not for too much longer. As Banky came through, and in an emotional finish to that fight, Paul Banky became the champion. Zaragoza was finished off, as you can see, and Banky, and there's Paul tonight, enjoying the fights.
That's right.
Good to see him out here. Paul, as many of you may know, is suffering from AIDS at this point, but he is up and around and feeling as well as possible, I guess, that being the situation. And we've seen him here at the fights, and he looks in pretty good condition.
And wasn't Zaragoza the face of a competitor as we watched that fight from 1990? His face just bloodied. His championship taken by Banky. It was, I think, by all odds, the fight of the year.
Well, and that's what you got to do to beat Zaragoza. He's not going to just give it up to you.
No.
He's certainly not going to just lay down or give up in his corner. You got to beat this man.
He only had seven losses in his career, and that was one of them that you watched with us in a little clip of the action back in 1990. Producer Jared Romano going all out tonight. He's showing us replays and clips and everything, and that's great. I tell you, you may not see Zaragoza again, for if he should lose this, as he has told Fernando, he will hang him up. Had a great champion and a great fighter. And trying to get still another title as he battles away with Acero Sanchez here in round number six.
Zaragoza does not have a classic style, Tom. I don't think you could call him a boxer, or you couldn't call him a slugger. And he's just, he'll wing punches at different angles. He reminds me a little of Bazooka Limon in the way that he fights. They kind of come from wide angles at times, roundhouse punches. But he's very effective with it.
And they are almost wrestling each other above us. It's Delgado having to separate these two warriors. A cut high in the forehead. Zaragoza cut over the right eye. His face has been bloody. Acero Sanchez remains unmarked. He's in the gold trunks. Blood flows from the cut over the right eye. Can pretty well stop the flow of blood from out of the forehead or the hairline of Zaragoza, but that right eye cut is really a troublesome thing. Tough to stop. Zaragoza up by a point after six rounds in this 12-round title scrap. Zaragoza, the challenger. Acero Sanchez in gold is the current WBC champion. Nice right to the body, the left hand to the head by Acero Sanchez.
utilizing his quickness there, Tom. He's a quicker puncher, and plus he punches straighter than does Zaragoza. It would seem that he could beat Daniel to the punch.
Again, the punt flows from the cut in the hairline. The result of a butt. Zaragoza's had his face bloodied since the end of round one. Cut over the right eye, and then a headbutt two rounds later. So bleeding has been a constant companion with him tonight. Left hand looked better than it was. The right hand, not a bad shot by Zaragoza.
Well, there's an action fighter for you.
Boy.
He comes out smoking, and he's a quickly developing fighter in this weight division, Tom.
Yes. I was thinking about that when you had listed the people, and we spoke of Marco Antonio Barrera. Magana'd like to fight him. I don't know of any guys that are ready to fight Marco Antonio Barrera.
It would seem that way. He seems head and shoulders, it appears to me, the best in this weight division.
If you're keeping track of the scoring at home, remember that Sanchez had a point deducted back in the fourth round, and that has made a very close fight even closer.
Tom, one punch that is becoming quite effective here for Acero Sanchez, he's throwing quick right hands as a lead punch from his right shoulder, right from his right shoulder, not drawing it back, just real quick, and he's landing in with regularity in this round.
Zaragoza pulls him up against the ropes and hits him a couple of shots to the body. I always thought the right hand lead was the best way to say hello to a southpaw anyway. Zaragoza, he gets a left in return, and he barrels into Sanchez as he has Sanchez up against the ropes.
This late rally by Zaragoza could cost Sanchez the round. He'd been dominating till that point.
He landed a couple of pretty good left hooks of his own right there. Closing minutes of round seven. We've got a dandy here. We'll be back.
Acero Sanchez landed most of the punches, but the biggest punch of the round was landed, a left hook by Zaragoza with about 30 seconds to go in the round. That makes it a tough, puts the judges in a quandary, Tom, because Acero Sanchez was dominating the round up until that point, but a late rally landed three or four real hard punches. Is that enough to get Zaragoza the round?
I don't know. Acero Sanchez came back after that and landed two or three pretty good lefts of his own. Not nearly as big time as the one that Zaragoza hit him with, but they were scoring punches. I mentioned Jesse Magana. He'll be in against Robinson Cuesta November the 27th. Monday right after Thanksgiving. He'll be defending his NABO 122-pound title. Magana has really come a long way in his career after a very shabby start. We're watching action in round number eight of this title bout.
No knockdown.
No. Of this title bout scheduled for 12 rounds.
Short punch by Zaragoza, Tom. Usually he needs to land from long distance wide punches, but he actually got a short, quick one in that time and surprised Acero Sanchez.
Pretty good body shots thrown by Zaragoza.
Yeah, that was good stuff there against the ropes. He'd probably like to have Acero Sanchez there a lot, but the champion, I don't think, is going to allow that.
Again, that spread eagle wide stance by Acero Sanchez.
Hold it.
They're watching the action in round number eight. Neither man has been down. Oh, Zaragoza bullying his way around the ring. Trying to out-muscle Sanchez as much as anything else.
Well, you're right. He wants to maul him, Tom.
Yeah.
He wants to turn it into a street fight.
Yeah. And it was he that was complaining about maybe some bar room or street fight-like tactics early in this fight. I don't know. All right, round eight coming to a close. Tough fight. Tough one to score. We'll be back.
November 92 saw a 12-round
war. War is broken out in the middle of the ring.
That's one of the best rounds in heavyweight history ever.
And Holyfield is down. The champ down for the second time in his career.
And new heavyweight champion of the world, ready, Big Daddy Bow.
1 year later, another classic battle.
Has come out smoking.
He's a big man with a big punch.
Oh my. We had a paratrooper come into the ring. And that is it. They're still fighting. Holy shit, landed a left against Bo.
And once again, heavyweight champion of the world, defenders.
Holyfield wins it.
Friday, Bo Holyfield 3, here on Premier Sports.
Took the title from Tracy Patterson in 1993, making a second title defense against Daniel Zaragoza, a man who has had three world titles in his long boxing career, trying for number four. A lot of people thought he'd done that when these two guys fought back in June in Ledyard, Connecticut. But the draw and the crown stayed with Hector Acero Sanchez. Dick Young, veteran boxing official, sitting to our right. He's one of the judges scoring here at ringside.
The last time Zaragoza had fought for the title, before that fight with Acero Sanchez, Tom, a couple of years ago, he had fought Tracy Harris Patterson and been stopped by Patterson in that fight. But since then, he had been undefeated in six straight wins before
That's
that
right.
draw against Acero Sanchez. He's been pretty busy.
16 title fights. Zaragoza's hat. Well, we don't mean to denigrate the efforts of these two guys, but we told you early on this was not going to be a pretty fight. These are two rough and tumble guys. They come at you from every possible angle.
It's an intriguing fight, though. Interesting to watch, Tom. Clashing styles here between these two.
Zaragoza nails Sanchez with a couple of solid shots.
And did you see a good, experienced veteran move there by Zaragoza? Zaragoza hit him the left, and then as Acero Sanchez came into him, he pushed him back and then hit him another left hook.
Sanchez gets a chopping right hand in return. I should say Zaragoza from Sanchez. Left hand in the middle of the face of Sanchez brings a roar from the crowd. They are heavily partisan in favor of Zaragoza.
Up on the eye of Daniel Zaragoza in that last round. As they came in close, they were just wailing away. Look at that clash of heads, and Zaragoza had another cut open above the right eye as a result of that headbutt in round number nine.
They used to call Chuck Wepner the Bayonne bleeder. I tell you, Daniel Zaragoza bleeds almost without any provocation, but he really opens up with headbutts. right over his right eye.
Well, Tom, you fight 60 times in your career, you're going to have a lot of scar tissue.
Well, there's no question about it. And every one of his fights have been just like this. I mean, wild, reckless affairs. No holds barred, all out. Big right hand by Zaragoza as he continues to apply the pressure, trying to back Acero Sanchez into a corner. I'm going to bring up a moot point for you here. If this fight continues the pace, and I think it's a very close, very tough fight, and Zaragoza doesn't do anything towards stopping the champion or knocking him down, does the champion keep his belt?
Well, I believe that if you edge a champion by a point, you deserve the decision in the championship. You know, it's all about a fight. No one ever laid down a rule that says you have to slaughter a champion to win it. I don't know where that myth came about. There have been close decisions, a lot of them. I think we're probably headed for another one here tonight, Tom.
I do, too. Sanchez, the champion, is in the gold trunks. Zaragoza at 35. Maybe involved in his last hurrah. If he doesn't win tonight, he reportedly has said he will retire as an active fighter. He has three youngsters. He wants to spend some time with them. He would like to manage and or train fighters in the future. Not get too far away from boxing. It has been his life. If he wins the title tonight, why then he'll be involved in more boxing title defenses as the champion.
You take a look at them, though, you know, he's 7 years older than Acero Sanchez, and he looks, his face, 27 years older.
Yes, and you have to marvel at the obvious great conditioning he's always in. Great shape. Nice left by Sanchez. We'll be back. Out they come for round number 11. It is scheduled for 12. The WBC Super Bantamweight title. The man in the gold trunks is the champion. The man in blue wants the title. And the question comes out of the truck like a shot out of the night. Who's winning? Good question. Rich Morata's got Zaragoza up by a point. I think it is every bit that close.
And remember that Acero Sanchez had a point deducted.
In the fourth round.
As he did in the first fight, had a point deducted, taken away from him. And still he was able to get that draw.
Zaragoza continues to bleed. There's a gash high in his forehead, right in the middle of his forehead, in the hairline. There's another one halfway up above his right eye. And there is a slit right over his right eye, all of which, from time to time, have bled throughout this fight. It started back at the end of round number one. Nice exchange. Zaragoza landing a pretty good right hand.
He has not, however, Tom, hurt Acero Sanchez yet to the extent that he did in their first meeting. And I felt that he was much more dominant in that fight, even though it ended up in a draw, than he is tonight.
He just walked into a very stiff jab with the left hand. Sanchez hit him a straight-on punch. Boy, it's been a great card here tonight. A rather weird ending.
You know, Daniel just can't walk away like that. I think he just got another cut.
And now he is mimicking the moves of Sanchez as if to say, you're always lowering your head. Well, I think earlier in this fight, we showed you very graphically how the two men's heads came together simultaneously. Nobody trying to institute that kind of a move. So I think Zaragoza may be begging the situation a bit.
The new cut is underneath the left eye. He has got, by my count, Tom, four separate cuts.
Yes. And that's kind of a weird headbutt to get a cut under the eye, Rich. I'm not saying it can't happen, but it is kind of a weird spot to have it surface. In fact, that is well down the cheek. Almost below the cheekbone under the left eye. Zaragoza would never fool anybody on the panel of What's My Line. The man is a professional fighter. And everything, every look about him tells you. Nailed up Sanchez with a pretty good left hand. There's another. Chopping right hand by Sanchez at the bell.
Zaragoza, very aggressive. There's another headbutt in the corner, but that one definitely was caused by Acero Sanchez. But Zaragoza walking right through with the headbutt that time, Tom, and just opening up with both hands. He's just, what a bloody mess is Daniel Zaragoza.
Not nearly as bloody as 1990 against Banky, but certainly he has shown the fruits of 11 very tough rounds. Here's the champion.
Acero Sanchez, Zaragoza leading the cheers in his corner.
105 to 103 would appear that Sanchez will have to knock Zaragoza out to win it.
Well, Tom, except there were many, many close rounds here. I usually feel pretty confident in my scoring, but this one could have a wide divergence of viewpoints from the judges.
So here they are with the final 3 minutes. Zaragoza tried to win the title. Acero Sanchez. Trying to keep it. Bear in mind, the crowd is heavily partisan towards Zaragoza. Whatever he does, it'll be magnified.
Have fought 24 pretty terrific rounds.
Haven't they? Pretty good left hand by Sanchez. Slowed Zaragoza down. Zaragoza with blood streaming from any one of four openings in his forehead, in the hairline, over the right eye, under the left eye.
Acero Sanchez, who's landed the cleaner blows to the head.
Yes. Yep. This is round 12 in this title defense for Acero Sanchez.
Champions had a very good 12th round so far.
Yes. By Zaragoza thrilled nobody except his partisan supporters. They really are not very effective. Sanchez has really had the best of this round. Whether it's enough to carry the day, if indeed he is trailing on some scorecards. He had a point taken away in the fourth round, remember. Blood streaming down the right side of the face of Zaragoza. It hasn't been pretty. It has been a very tough fight for both men.
You know, you look at Hector Acero Sanchez, he looks like he could fight another 12 rounds.
Yes. I'm sure deep down inside he doesn't want to. Seconds remain, at least not tonight. certainly going to be vocal one way or the other. We'll find out how the judges saw it, but we'll pause first for this message. Brought to you by Restore Automotive Products, bringing advanced technology to your car and truck through innovative automotive products. Well, what a night here at the Great Western Forum, the ring full of people. Jimmy Lennon Jr. has been busy collecting the scorecards of the three ringside judges. He has them. They've tabulated them. Is Zaragoza the new WBC Super Bantamweight champ? Is Acero Sanchez continuing as the champion? Only Jimmy knows, and in a moment we'll all know. Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, and after 12 rounds of boxing here at the home of championship boxing, we have a split decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Dick Young scores the bout 114-113, Hector Acero Sanchez. Judge at ringside, Terry Smith scores the bout 116-112, Daniel Zaragoza. Judge at ringside, Tommy Tomihara scores the bout 115-112 in favor of the winner and new champion, Daniel.
Super Bantamweight champion, the fourth time he has held the title, a very close fight, one judge had it 116-112, and even with a point deduction for Acero Sanchez, I can't believe that it was that disparate in the scoring, but that's the way the judges saw it. The others were just a point apart.
It was very tight, Tom. I had it 114-113 for Zaragoza. I felt he earned the decision, although the one-point margin in my card really, with that one-point deduction of Acero Sanchez actually making the difference. It was a very, very tight fight, and I tell you, there's a lot of happiness here at the Forum here this evening over the crowning of a 35-year-old new champion.
Yep. One imagines or wonders how much longer he can continue. He is obviously in amazing shape. A man his age going that many tough rounds. Fernando, if you will, please.
Daniel, you made it. Daniel, la hiciste.
Sí, afortunadamente, Acero venía ahora mucho mejor que la vez pasada. Afortunadamente, yo tampoco me confié. Hicimos un pleito intenso, como se vio. Me golpeó bastante más ahora. Pero ganamos, y esto es la recompensa.
He said that this is a reward. Basically, he said that Acero Sanchez was harder than he was the first time, and it was a much tougher fight. He also got a hit a little bit more, but this is the reward. All those cuts, all through headbutts, las cortadas todas por cabezazos?
Todas por cabezazos, desde la del primer round, pero tal vez no fueron a propósito accidentales, así se defiende él, ni hablar.
Okay, they said that they were all through headbutts, but they were probably accidental. So congratulations, new world champ. Felicidades.
Yes. Gracias. Un saludo a mi esposa y a mis hijos.
Thanks. Hi to his wife and his children. Back to ringside.
Just for the record, he's now won 51 fights while losing 7. And all of those cuts, I made it 5, Rich, and counting, I'm still losing blood. Congratulations, champ. We'll see you again.